the customer collaboration over contract negotiation. Agile software development, the specific, like there could be specific for working with the users or the stakeholders. Like it's common to work with the stakeholders. The stakeholders usually put together a list of the requirements, they hand it over to the development team, and then the regular checking and iteration is done with the stakeholders instead of users. This is the common problem when this happens. Usually the software at the end is happily accepted by the stakeholders but doesn't necessarily work for the users. So there are some attempts to change this to really the user-centered model. And quite a consistent and coherent approach, design-driven development, which is generally turning design into the games and making it more fun and really centering on the users. Design-driven development is cool for the new projects. It's well defined, easy to start with. Still, like for bigger project, redesign stuff or any big experiments, it's probably good to learn more about the user-centered design and about the principles of it. And generally, the user-centered design is what we need to do really usable things. So in the user-centered design, the users are involved through the testing, through the initial phases of design, development, to the final phase. So all changes in the design are driven by user-centered evaluation. And the process is iterative. The more iteration, the high chance that all the issues will be fixed soon. At the output of the user-centered design, there should be a tool with really whole, satisfactory user experience. Okay, so the summary of the user-centered design would be really focus on the user and task, empirical evaluation of user response, and iterative design, like these three pieces. Okay, so what's next? Let's evaluate the product's usability. There are, again, multiple evaluation methods. I'll try to focus just on the three, which is the usability testing, which is the primary method which should provide the really empirical proof whether the software is usable or not. There is the usability compliance and heuristic evaluation. So the usability heuristics. The heuristics generally describe some attributes of the usable systems, and it's good to understand them. And the knowledge of the heuristic could be applied on evaluation of the software. So we can go one by one, for example, as part of some focus group, and we can look at the software together and try to evaluate by these heuristics whether it's met or not. Little disadvantage of the heuristic is that it could provide very good results, but often it cannot catch the most important issues, but it's really effective in catching the or severity usability issues. So this is the set of the heuristic which is the most often used. It's created by Jack. And there is another beautiful set which is like more extensive. It's used primarily, it was primarily used for the web application, but it's applicable also for other software. So quickly reading through is, know the user and you are not the user. Keep information for decision where must be and when the decision is needed. Error messages should actually mean something to the user and tell how to fix the problem. Consistency. Minimize the need for a mighty memory. Keep it simple. User should always know what is happening. The more you do something, the easier it should be to do it. User should control the system. Eliminate unnecessary decisions. The best journey has fewest steps. so shorten the distance between the user and the goal. The user should be able to do what they want and alert users to error before it gets worse. And users should always know what to do next. Okay, so these were the two examples of the usability heuristics. And usability testing. So this is the primary method. The testing should happen with the set of the representative users. So typically during the usability testing, the participants try to complete some typical task in the system, and observers watch, listen, and take notes. So the goal of usability testing is to identify usability problems, collect qualitative and quantitative data, and determine the participant satisfaction with the product. So what we need to conduct the usability testing? Generally, we need some scenarios, so the typical task in the systems. We need the participants, which will be from the common user group, and we need to analyze and report the findings. And there is a chart which shows the success rate based on the number of participants. So generally, it's recommended for at least 4 participants. And the higher number of participants means that there will be a higher number of find issues. And the issues would have better proof, and we can also prioritize them correctly. So usability testing, the last example of evaluation is the usability compliance. So that's compliance to some written guidelines. There are some project-specific guidelines, for example, which the GNOME project have, KDE have, Apple, Android. The guideline should be compatible with the latest research, which usually it's true. And there are also some general guidelines which could be generally applied to anything, web applications, GUI, or TUI tools. The really nice set of guidelines is maintained by Health and Human Services Department, and it covers over 200 specific guidelines with good examples, bad examples, explanation, and recommendation for implementation. And understanding these guidelines is really useful for it really provides good basis for developing usable interfaces. So again, there are some examples of the guidelines. Usability in command line. So the same what works in GUI should apply in text user interface as well. So I have 2 examples here. I cover one of them. We have a tool, run me every time you need status. And there is some common opt and show status option. What might be wrong here? So it seems that this tool is expected to run quite often. So maybe we should make it more efficient when the users type this. So the name should be probably shorter. And also, why to explicitly define the common option? The common option should be the default one. So this probably don't need to be explicitly stated. And same for the show status. Like the tool probably should show status in the default configuration because users expect that they will know what's happening. Okay, redesign lessons learned. Probably everyone heard some horrors or had personal experience with failed redesign. And it's common, it's expected, because users are sensitive to changes and they are very picky to remove options. So often the inconvenience caused by redesign overweighs the benefits of the new solutions. The biggest danger is alienating the existing users. Because often the redesign focuses on the new set of the users and try to bring the new users to the community. But the existing users are also important, and they are usually the heart of the community. So it's recommended to apply the user-centered design and engage them early. Okay, so I'm out of the time. So I missed the visual design and attractiveness. Sorry about that. Maybe sometime later. Thanks for attention. Are there any questions? Too much information, okay. Thanks.
You ask what to do in this usability test, and it's actually handling usability. For example, let me tell you an example. If Windows is missing a library, it doesn't tell you that it is missing the library. It's giving you completely some vague message that the application files will start, blah, blah, blah. Mm-hmm. Because 99% of users don't know what is the library, and if one of them knows later, this message actually doesn't tell.
Okay, so you mean like, do you require usability testing, like how to report this thing, or?
Yes, I mean, if you make a usability testing on some sample of users, then you may find that the best thing is to make completely vast message that application failed to start. And if there is one user who is willing to fix the problem, who is willing to download the library from the internet and install it, you can do it because the message doesn't fail it. So that
Okay. Yeah. So I think in this certain case you can you can measure compare like how many users were able to achieve it and how many steps they need. So you can then compare like the two more different solution for
sure,
like this.
If you are targeting for a general sample of users, then you are hampering the usability for the more advanced.
Yeah. So. For the advanced users, usually you can if you want the same tool be working well for the advanced and simple users, need some configuration options. Okay, thank you.